Stanford. This is a name known throughout the world, one of the top schools in the world. Leland Stanford is a very important person to understand Silicon Valley modern day culture. He was born in New York in the early 1800s. He set up a law practice in Wisconsin, and then after 5 years, his building that he practiced law in had a fire and burned down. He had to recreate his life, and he followed his brothers to California to take part in the gold rush in the 1850s by setting up a retail store to sell the miners the different provisions, the food, and the tools that they needed. When he was up in the mountains of California, he became very interested in the cooperative model that the mining communities had. There might be 5 to 9 miners all working on the same plot that didn't have any set defined roles. They would do whatever was necessary as a team to get that gold out of the ground. Sound familiar? Sound like working in a startup? So after he made billions of dollars in the rail industry, he founded Stanford University for his son. One of the key things of Stanford University that set it apart from the other East Coast or British schools is the focus on application into industry. He wanted to make sure that all students who went through Stanford were trained in a way to be industrious. So he had the product realization lab, which is where students from any department, from humanities, from engineering, from medicine, could go work with big tools to make things out of wood, to make things out of metal. So they'd be talking together at lunch, they'd be talking together over a sport, and they'd have an idea for how something in farming or something in mining could be done better, could be done easier. They would go to the product realization lab, they would talk to an instructor there about how to use the different machines for what they wanted to make, they would make a prototype, they would go show the prototype to the market surrounding Stanford University and get feedback on whether or not it was useful. Does that sound familiar? Does that sound like the lean startup method? Well, it was started with Stanford University in 1886 with the foundation of the school.